Birmingham GTRCs here again with the A959B with my A979 body shell. Basically, I'm just giving you a look at how I've rewired it. As you can see, it's all up front. With the body from the A979 gives me a bit more room up front, so I've got as much of the weight as possible in the car up front. You can see I've got my receiver in there, which is kind of on the side where I've got my gyro, and then I've got that just on the side there. So I've got all the weight up front, all the wires up front, my 60 amp ESC in the middle, my 4,370 kV motor. It's just a 2S in there at the moment. I've got a 38 tooth spur. I downsized it from the 42 standard to the old, I think it's the original A959 spur, which is a 38, so I fitted that on. A little trimming was needed and so on. As you can see, it's very close to the bracket, so I trimmed that up to fit. 27 tooth pinion. And yeah, as you can hear, guys, I mean, that was clocking away before and grinding when I first fitted up that spur. You can hear now how nice that sounds. That is a lovely mesh, guys. So hopefully with a nice smooth rolling car, I should get some good speeds, and we'll see if these wheels can hold out and if the car can hold out and we can get it over. I think my last speed run on camera was 56 mile an hour or something like that. So I'm hoping to get it over 60 mile an hour, guys. Yeah, I did a gear calculation speed on radio control speed or something like that website, and I calculate the gears, you know, the pinion gears and pinion spur and so forth, and basically, you know, calculated it, and it says it will do 101 mile an hour. We're not going to get 101 mile an hour, but I'm hoping to get pretty close. If I get over 70 mile an hour out of this little car, I'd be well happy. I'm hoping to get it all on camera too, and as you can see, I've got my GPS mounted in the back. So, and as I've shown you the body there, I've cut the back out of the bodywork, and I cut the back window out just to help release any dragging when that sits over there, that sits in the back, and you know, the GPS kind of just sticks out the back so you can still read it without having to keep taking the body off and so forth. Yeah, and I just left these little bolts that I use for my wheelie bar. I put extra long ones in just to stop the GPS hitting the floor or anything like that and damaging my GPS. So that's completely safe there. It's velcroed, stuck to the bottom in a little elastic band just to kind of really help it stay there. Yeah, guys, as you see, I've got a cat pack on there, six in there, and basically that wire's in there and the cat pack will just sit in there and it clips in. And yeah, so there's as least weight really. I mean, without the GPS on, it's less weight in the rear. The car drives lovely, but at the moment, you know, for the high speed runs and getting it on camera and giving you guys a look at what speeds I'm doing, I've got the GPS in the back, I've got extra weights in the front, little front spoiler just to help try keep the front end down. Of course, a solid drag bar on the rear. If I flip it on its side, as you can see, I've got extra weight underneath the bottom as well, just to, you know, keep that front end down and give it as much traction as possible. We'll see how long it holds out for. I'm gonna shelf this car soon, guys, because these bolts, you know, screwing to the motor mount, not tightening up as tight. You can feel that, you know, they're starting to give now and they'll just want to spin, so I could lose gear mesh, you know, trying. So I'm hoping it will hold out long enough for me to get that high speed run. And as you can see, my motor is right up against that central post, you know, that goes through that brace. Yeah, I literally just squeezed it in and it's given me the perfect mesh. You know, if I can get in there, and there is a little bit of play in there. You can probably hear a little bit of play. So it's not tight, but it's not loose. It's giving me a good mesh. I did have cylinder shocks on here, but I got a WD-40 on the, you know, just spraying it up and was WD-40 in it, which is, I don't really use WD-40 no more because for some parts it's not good. And getting WD-40 on those little O-ring things that are inside the shocks, basically with the cylinder ones, then it made it too slippery and then it was bouncing around with no friction. And then the next day, once they dried out, it was so sticky, you'd push it down and it just stay down. So yeah, I've gone back to having the shocks, and as you can see now, you know, it's, I'd prefer it to stay low like it used to, but I mean, I've got a little bit of movement in there, nothing crazy. I mean, you can see it's, I have to really give it a good push down to get it on the, you know, to hit the deck. But apart from that, yeah, it's lovely, guys. It drives okay. The only major issue I have with this car, and I've probably had and everybody's had from day one, is the steering, guys. It's just a nightmare trying to get this car to drive in a straight line. I'm going to try now. I've actually turned the gyro up really, really high, guys. I'm just trying to see if I can find a way that I can get this gyro to work with the car. I may end up just not running the gyro, but it does help, you know, a little. But then your car ends up having a really crazy wobble from the gyro at low speeds or high speeds, depending on where you turn the gain. You know, I'm just messing around with it and trying to see if I can find a balance. I did find having it really, really low worked. But if I get in there, I mean, it's really strapped in now. To take that out, I'd have to take, you know, all this ESC off and, you know, undo it all to keep adjusting it. So I'm going to see if I can find a tiny little screwdriver or something I can put in the little holes and turn it, really. I mean, what I should have done, really, is customed some little knobs for those dials, you know, and just glued it onto it or something so that they stick through the holes and I could turn it from the outside. But I'll see if I can find something sharp enough and thin enough to go in there and adjust it so I don't have to keep taking all this off. You know, I've wired it in as neat as I can and cable tied it all down. So if it does need adjusting, I'll have to find a way. I've left enough space to get in there. I'll just remove this wheel to get in there and I can adjust the adjustments from the outside. Apart from that, guys, I just want to really get this out for one more good run, for a higher speed run, and then I can shelf it along with my HSP. I've got another buggy I'm building at the moment. It is a kit car, you know, nothing expensive, but yeah, I'm not going to film too much of putting that together because there's videos out there of it already. The only difference is I've got the newest version. I haven't seen a video online of the new version. There's not much difference between the old version, probably just the body looks different, and you know, maybe some small minor part on the car might be different from the old one. But you'll see what that is soon. I'm just in the process of building it and filming a little bit as I go along. Any problems I come up against building a new one and letting guys, you know, just do a little comparison. But until then, guys, I'm, you know, it's a nice day out today. So I'm going to take this out and just have a little fun and see what I can do with this gyro and get it to drive straight. And yeah, this is my little A959B drag car, you know. Haven't gone too extreme with it, you know. I'm not looking for the ultimate drag car or anything like that. Just something for a bit of fun, you know. I'm always trying to aim for that middle bracket, you know. I don't want a standard car and I don't want a silly over-the-top car. I just want something in the middle that we can all do, you know, and we can all have fun with, and, you know. So this is it, really. Yeah, it took me a long time. I've been messing with these A959Bs. Was my first car, and yeah, it's taught me a lot about cars being fully upgradable and stuff. And this is the car that basically, you know, got me back into RC hobbies. So this car is gonna be, you know, my number one, you know, car to remember, and you know, and what got me into the hobby and made me enjoy it. So yeah, anyone buying an A959B and you've never driven RC cars before, or you're getting back into the hobby and, you know, the last time you used to drive a car like me used to be petrol, then yeah, you're going to love this electric, you know, A959B, and just, you know, upgrading parts and finding out for yourself what works, what doesn't work. Or you can watch my videos and save yourself the hassle. But yeah, it's time to get this out now, guys, and just have a little fun while the weather's still nice and do some more testing. Yeah, so I'll just get this out and have a little run. I've got my lights in the front and rear there as well. There you are. So, sorry about this, I'm using my... let's pick that up. So I've got the gyro really... That gyro is really strong, guys, so I've got a feeling at very, very low speeds this thing's gonna wobble like crazy. But I'm just gonna show you what the difference is between having a high gain setting on the gyro and a low gain setting. So this is with the gyro high. And that's with a 2S at the moment, 40C discharge. Beast. Yeah, let's take it outside. Here we go, guys, to the wobble. And there we go, this is with the gyro set high. See, it's wobbling on its own. Not touching the steering, guys. See that wobble there, look. And that's with a high gain setting, so it's no good really. Alright, so now I'm gonna unclick the gyro and see what it does. Okay, gyro's off. See how it drives with the gyro off. Doesn't want to drive in a straight line. Yeah, very difficult to steer in a straight line. You can see it's all over the place, guys. I'm barely touching the steering. Just pulling to the left a little. Let's do a bit of trimming, see if that helps. Doesn't like her. Doesn't like not having a gyro, guys. It really doesn't. Barely touching the throttle. Yeah, don't like not having a gyro, so now let's turn the gyro down. Alright, let's turn the gyro down, guys, and see how that goes with the gyro turned down. Okay, so I've turned the gyro down. You can hear it working, but barely doing anything. Let's see what it does now. Way better. Way better with a gyro lower, guys. So as you can see, you gotta have the gain really low. It's not the perfect surface, it's a little uneven and rough, but way better to drive. Way better to drive, guys, with the gyro turn low. So that's the settings I'm going to work with, and yeah, I'll just take it out and have a blast, some nice open space, and have a race with a few mates. And that, the next time you see this one out, guys, I'll take it for a high speed run and a bit of drag racing. This is Birmingham GT RCs. Birmingham GTRCs representing. Stay tuned, guys. Like and subscribe. Okay, guys. As you know, I got a Lupton here. Yeah, I'm just stripping it all out, guys. Taking out this stuff so I can use it on something else. Basically, I just took this out. You know, I got my little A959B up to scratch, that's ready to go. So while I was at it, I thought, let's get this Lupton, you know. Well, basically there was nothing wrong with it. I would just take it out and bash it, take it out and drive it and have a bit of fun with it. So I took it out, dropped it on the floor. As soon as I went to drive, I started doing donuts. I was like, well, what's going on here? It's, you know, spinning the wheels real easy. So I thought I'd change the surface and get out onto the road. And it still felt really, you know, weird. I'm accelerating and this thing was doing 50 mile an hour, as you saw from one of my videos. You know, when I'm accelerating and it's not pulling away, it's almost like it's just wheel spinning like it's on ice. And I was thinking, well, this don't seem right. It's making a lot of noise, but it's not moving. Wish I did film it, but probably wasn't much to see. But yeah, guys, the reason why it was struggling to drive, because when I brought it back and had a look, I've got one drive shaft. I'm driving with one wheel, literally not rear wheel drive. This is one wheel drive, guys. It's completely bossed off. And I have no idea when this happened. I've got a feeling in transportation, you know, because I've been doing this moving house thing and all that. I reckon I might have loaded something on it and broke it. You know, might have put a bit of pressure on it. It might have been packed away wrong. Something might have slipped in the car, you know, and literally snapped it off. I have no idea when and where or anything. And looking at these dog bones, it's a shame, really, because they are quite chunky dog bones, which I was wondering if they would have fitted into my HSP. But I might order another set of these or set of four because they look like the same length and everything. And they are actually definitely thicker. So I'm going to look at ordering some more of these from the manufacturer, see if I can get some of these dog bones are nice and thick and use them in my HSP. And hopefully I shouldn't bend them so easily. But yeah, I'm missing one, guys. Completely snapped off. So yeah, I've had it for a while. It was a cheap buggy. I think I paid £60 for, and yeah, it's done 50 mile an hour, brushless upgraded. I cannot remember what that motor was, what KV or anything. I know it's a 3S, but I can't remember what the KV is or anything on it. You can see the wires are tiny, so I mean, it's literally 3S is the limit. And I had a custom, had to custom fit my servo. So I'm not actually going to take the servo out, and I'm not going to take this motor out, because I did put a bit of super glue and all kinds just to make sure it stayed in place. So I'm going to leave the motor in, because I know this motor can get this car to do what it can do. I may one day buy another gearbox. This is my second gearbox. It was literally a brand new gearbox. So I may buy another one. I may do. But I just don't think this car really can handle the 3S power that I'm putting through it, you know. So, yeah, guys, my Lockton getting benched. So it's a good job I got another car to work on here, guys. You know, yeah, that's what I had, guys. You can see, look at the bodywork on it, guys. I've had this for a while. I've been out with it, running it loads. And look at the body. It's barely even got a scratch on it. Because I can be totally honest with you, as much as I've rolled it a couple times, this thing doesn't really roll. The actual stability is quite good, do you know what I mean? For what it is, it doesn't really flip itself over. I think that's as well because I adjusted all the suspension. You can see it sits low. There's no movement there. It sits really low. So it used to ride really well. It'd just be spinning the back wheels a lot and doing donuts and all that. But yeah, you know, it is what it is, guys. Just thought I'd let you have a look at that as well before I close off on my video. This is Birmingham GT RCs. Over and out. Like and subscribe. Stay tuned for more. And thanks for watching, guys. Cheers.